Hey, how's it going? My name is Maciej and today I want to talk to you about switching to a MacBook Air M1 for photography and video editing. I'm a lifetime Windows user and I've built my own PCs many times. I know, the M2 is just around the corner, but it's not here yet, and this one is. I got this in February when everyone was expecting a new MacBook Air announcement in March, but I couldn't wait. I needed a computer right away. I've been working on it exclusively since then, putting it to the test every day. So here's the usage scenario, so you can compare it with your own requirements. I'm a full-time photographer and I shoot a lot of video. My main camera for photography is a medium format Fujifilm GFX 50R. I shoot video with Canon EOS R most of the time in 1080p, but I wanted to switch to 4K. I use Mavic 2 Pro, Mavic Mini 2, and DJI Action 2. Additionally, I work with Sony ZV-1 4K files quite frequently. So this review is focused mainly on Lightroom, Photoshop, and Premiere Pro. Traveling light is very important to me. I did a fair amount of travel with my custom-built desktop PC, and I hated every second of it. I think a small part of me died every time I had to drag it down the stairs, pack my car, and set it up over and over again. So at some stage, I had to buy an extra set of everything, just so I can travel with my computer and monitor on me, without the need to rewire everything in both locations. Trust me, that's not the way to live your life. I have a Microsoft Surface Pro 5 with i7 and 16GB of RAM. For some reason, it is extremely slow. I had some issues with the battery and the power supply. I did a factory reset a couple of times. It was replaced by Microsoft. But it's the same story with the replacement. It's completely useless when switched to a battery power and slightly improved when charging. I work and live in Norway and Poland, so traveling with my desktop computer is not an option. Most of my daily work is real estate photography. For example, I have to import 3 photo shoots, make my selections, export, and send the files to production. These are repetitive tasks that can't be automated, hence they require super responsive software and hardware. My Surface Pro was so slow, I could go shower while importing photos in Lightroom. Sending it for repair from Norway would ground me for more than a week. Not to mention that I don't want to invest any money in this direction anymore. So I've watched almost everything on YouTube about the new M1 Max. Almost every video is showing a ridiculous amount of 4K footage on multiple tracks in Premiere Pro using a basic MacBook Air M1 with 8GB of RAM. That was very impressive. We all know that. But then I've watched some disturbing videos with the beach ball doing its thing with some basic filters in Photoshop or struggling with some codecs. I was very close to go with a 14-inch MacBook Pro to get as much computing power as possible, but in the end, I thought I will transition within reason. Also, I think it's not a matter of more power, but rather a compatibility issue. It's an upgrade from basic model to 16GB of RAM and 500GB SSD. It seems that 8GB would be okay, but no. Drop that wishful thinking. I decided to get a decent external drive and an SD card dongle. The Samsung T7 is pretty fast. But speaking of dongles, I really don't like them. You think you'll be fine with this thing just hanging on the side, but it escalates quickly. I find it difficult to get the right one. I would recommend reading the description closely. I noticed that very often they say the dongle has the interface 3.2, but it's only this part that goes into computer. The SD card reader and USB ports are 3.0, so you can guess the overall speed. Since I'm working on my Samsung T7 external drive, it's a bit slow to transfer the images from the SD card, because the card reader is 3.0, and this will slow down the entire process. I know that some people also complained about the power output on the Thunderbolt ports. It might be too low to use with 2 external SSD drives. I have no issues with a card reader, SSD, and a regular external drive connected at once with the addition of an HDMI monitor. I don't use the external monitor that often. It's a BenQ with hardware calibration, but the calibration always fails with an HDMI cable. It took me a very long time to realize that you need a DisplayPort cable for proper calibration with this monitor. I have Lightroom, Photoshop, and Premiere Pro open all the time. Starting with Lightroom, importing files is really fast. probably the fastest I've seen. Generating initial previews is very good. Everything works the way it should. I think this saves me almost half an hour a day. I mean half an hour a day, every day. If that's the price I have to pay for dealing with dongles, so be it. But that is the reason why MacBook Pro with a maxed out SSD and a card reader is very appealing to me. And I'm pretty sure the marketing team at Apple knows that very well. I need a computer to save time so I can live my life. By the way, it's about time you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel since you made it this far. As you probably know, Lightroom is known for being super slow with importing images from an SD card on its own. So I used Photo Mechanic for that for many years. It works very well on M1. I think I will keep using it. Not because of its speed, but Lightroom still sucks at selecting images you want to import. This is very useful when you don't want to import all of your images, which is what I do most of the time. Otherwise, I'd be out of storage in a week. If you have the same issue, you can try Photo Mechanic on Windows and Mac OS. There's also an interesting app called Narrative Select. This is only for Mac OS. It looks very promising, but the trial will let you import only 6 times per month, I think, which was one day for me. Also, I'm not convinced about their pricing strategy. I haven't noticed any major problems in Photoshop, opening multiple large files and sending photos as layer from Lightroom was flawless. I tried a variety of filters. I wasn't able to replicate some issues other people had. Maybe it was a different version, I don't know. Since I do a lot of real estate photography, I use Sky Replacement quite often. I was hoping it would be much faster on launch, but it's not. If you shoot real estate, architecture, or any kind of photography that requires Sky Replacement, check out the link in the description for my Sky Replacement Master Collection shot with a medium format camera. It works with Luminar and Photoshop. My biggest fear was video editing. Adobe is trying to catch up with M1, but there's some more work to be done. So far so good, it simply works. Super responsive with 4K footage. I haven't tried 37 tracks of 8K video because I don't need that. I don't regret getting 16GB of RAM and 500GB SSD. I work exclusively on an external drive just in case I need to work on something on the go. That way I have some space available to me at all times. I was prepared to learn Final Cut Pro, which to my surprise is a 90 days trial, but there's no need. Premiere Pro works just fine with all of my footage. I want to use 4K C-Log with EOS R soon, but for now, I'm sticking to 1080p. It's just my current lens selection in relation to my needs and a 4K video crop on EOS R, which is not a bad thing, but that's how it is for now. Also, 1080p C-Log is slowing down on this computer once you start to color grade. I had to use proxies for my drone footage on my desktop PC, but this MacBook has no problem with DJI 4K video. You can scrub in real time all day long. This might be a different experience depending on the cameras you use. My biggest issue with it is the performance when you double the playback speed. This is not working properly even at the lowest preview resolution. It also seems to be unrelated to the source file codec. It was a very positive experience to see how synchronize function works. I was completely blown away by the speed of syncing nearly 45 minutes long Canon footage with multiple files from DJI Action 2. Battery life is amazing. It's not 18 hours amazing unless you just stare at the desktop, but my Surface Pro was holding for less than an hour, so I'm easy to please. Also, Surface Pro was visibly slower on the battery, and that is the case with all Intel-based laptops. That seems to be completely different with this one. I don't see any difference when it's unplugged. In terms of build quality, well, I've dropped it and I've stepped on it and it's still doing fine. I know the announcement is coming soon. Maybe there's a new MacBook Air M2 on the way, maybe there's not. Probably not if you're living in Russia. Otherwise, you can wait or get this one now. Overall, it's a fantastic tool at a very good price. Although, I don't think I will ever buy a laptop without the SD card reader built in. And I don't think they should be allowed to sell them like that either. That's it for today. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.